Hello, my name is Louisa Ward and I'm a beauty therapist. I run my own private practice and work here at the Beauty Academy. Today I'm going to demonstrate to you a facial. I'm going to do the removal of eye makeup, two cleanses, an exfoliate, a steam, a massage, an application of a mask, removal of the mask, a tone and moisturise. So if we begin, take two pieces of cotton pad, dampen them, spread them out, and apply a small amount of eye makeup remover. Spread onto both pads and apply onto the eyes with a light pressure. As the eye makeup remover is working into the mascara, with two more pads, dampened once again, apply some more eye makeup remover, ensuring that our pads are not dripping onto our client's face. Support one side of the lip, sweep over and back, and then support the other side and sweep over and back to remove any traces of lipstick. Come back to our client by touching the temples. Light pressure onto the eye pads. Bring together and sweep out. Pressure, and we're going to repeat the process. This time, take one cotton pad, split into two. Make into two half moon shapes, place underneath the eye. With a cotton bud, apply a small amount of eye makeup remover and roll the eyelashes, pushing any traces of mascara onto the cotton pad beneath. The other eye. Then with two more cotton pads, dampen, apply our eye makeup remover. In the first stage, apply on top of the eyes. Light pressure, bring up the centre, fold and wipe away any excess. Any mascara remaining, repeat the process again. We can now go on to our first cleanse. So if we apply some cleanser into the palm of our hand, a little bit of water, warm in our palms, ensure there's no drip coming from our hands. Light pressure on the temples, sweep across the chest, up the neck, brace the chin, palm a stroke either the side of the chin. Catch the top lip and lightly circle up the cheeks till we reach the nose. At this point, ensure we place pressure on one nostril at a time so we keep the airways open. Circle on the forehead. And light pressure at the temples to finish. With our damp sponges, take away any excess water, pressure at the temples, sweep across the chest, sweep up the neck, turn our sponges over, across the chin, not forgetting the top lip, up the cheeks, one side of the nose at a time, and across the forehead. And we've completed our first cleanse. Now, apply more cleanser into the palm of the hand. A little bath of water. Take off any excess. Pressure up the temples. Sweep across. Sweep across. Up the neck. Brace the chin. Palm stroking the side of the face. And the other side. Don't forget the top lip. Small circles around the sides of the face. Alternate circles up the nose to the forehead. And then we do a scissor action across the forehead. This helps relax our client with a light massage. Sweep down. And back into our chin brace. Our palms stroking. And the other side. Don't forget our top lip. Circles up the cheeks. Either side of the nose. Onto the forehead. And our scissor action. And last and final time, sweep down, brace the chin, palm stroking. Not forgetting the top lip. Circle on the cheeks. Turn that circling on the nose. And again onto the forehead. You can finish this last routine with small circles just on the temples to relax. A light pressure, and then we can remove with our sponges. Take off any excess water, start at the temples, sweep across the chest, up the neck. The chin, not forgetting the top lip. Each side of the nose. And pressure at the temples. Ensuring there's no hair on the face. And there's no cleanser left. Just doing quick removal, just to ensure there's no cleanser left. Back all the way across the chest, up the neck. Not forgetting to turn our pads over, up the cheeks, either side of the nose, and pressure at the temples. You can just blot this to ensure our client isn't becoming too cold just by using a tissue lightly onto the chest area, pressure with the back of our hand, and wipe away. Then onto the face. Ensuring our client isn't claustrophobic, place a hole in the centre of our tissue over the nose, light pressure on the cheeks, forehead and chin, and pull up. We can now go on to exfoliation. Place a small amount of exfoliant into the palm of the hand. Warm it into the palm. Once again, pressure on the temples to tell our client we're going to proceed. Dab the exfoliator on. Come back down to the chin area and start to circle, ensuring we cover all the areas of the face in small circular movements. Round the cheeks, not forgetting the top lip, sides of the nose. Once again, alternate circles up the nose and onto the forehead. And this can be repeated. So back down to the chin, onto the cheeks, not forgetting the top lip, and onto the nose. And last and final time, onto the chin, top lip, and we can concentrate on areas that are particularly dry, which we can assess during our consultation. Around the sides of the nose and onto the forehead. Pressure at the temples again. And we'll move with our sponges. Pressure on at the temples, up the neck, over the chin. Cheeks and across the forehead and pressure. Pressure the temples and look at your client's face to see where there's any remaining exfoliant left we need to remove. Working in a nice, slow, relaxing rhythm to remove all the exfoliant. Take off any excess water with our tissue again. And if your client is claustrophobic, we may place the tissue on one side of the face. Pressure and remove. The other side, pressure, remove. And then the chin, nose, and forehead. We would now be ready to steam. You would turn your steamer on away from your client. Once you've got a good flow of steam, move it towards the back of the client and allow the steam to penetrate the skin. This can be left for up to 10 minutes depending on skin type. Ensure the steam is not too close to the face and your client is comfortable at all times. One thing to remember is to ensure the steam does not come up the face. Ensure it is always going down. Move the steamer away after 10 minutes and turn the steamer off. Blot to take off any excess water. And we're now ready to go on to our massage. Apply some oil in the palm of the hand. Warm. Light pressure at the temples. And into six full effleurage. So round the shoulders, back of the neck, up the chin, brace, up the nose, and back round to the temples. That's one full effleurage, so we'll repeat that six times. And our third time, over the chest, round the shoulders, round the back of the neck, up the chin, brace, around the cheeks, and back to the temples. So round the shoulders, giving a nice pressure. Feel any tense muscles at the back of the shoulders. The size of the nose, ensuring we don't block the airways. Giving a nice rhythm to relax our client. On our final effleurage, come up, brace, sides of the nose, back down, and circle on the top of the chest. Come round to a half effleurage, and repeat our circling. And for a third and final time, come round and repeat our circling. Just below the collarbone. Go straight into circling behind the shoulders, feeling that trapezius muscle, up to the back of the neck, half effleurage around the shoulders, and repeat. Last time, round the shoulders, a nice pressure with our fingertips circling behind the shoulders and up to the neck. Smooth this down with three half effleurage, so up to the back of the neck and back onto the chest. Come up and brace the chin. And then we can go into our scissor movement. So we come with two fingers over the lips and back over the chin. Then repeating with our other hand, over the lips and back over the chin. And that's three times on each side. So over the lips and back over the chin. Over the lips and back over the chin. And our final time, over the lips, back, over the chin. Come up, feel the cheekbone, and drain. So with our fingertips, we feel where the cheekbone reaches the nose, and drain down. Light pressure gliding up, and drain down. Come up the nose, ensuring we don't block the airways. Pressure on the occipital bone or the eye bone, and sweep round. So pressure up, and sweep below. Pressure up, and sweep below. And this is very good for our clients who have any kind of sinus problems or stress, just to help relieve that tension. our scissors on the forehead. And then we can sweep into our six full effleurage to finish. So nice slow rhythm. Really start to relax our client, ensuring they're comfortable at all times and your pressure is right for them. Final time, we sweep round, brace the chin, up over the cheeks, onto the forehead, and finish with some light circles just on the temples, getting slower and slower until we finish. All our hair is out of the way, and we're now ready to apply our mask. So with our mask in a bowl with a brush, paint on. Start at the jawline, up to the ear, and the other ear, filling the chin, don't forget the top lip, come up onto the cheeks, leaving a nice gap around the eyes, up to the temples on either side, fill in the nose, showing we cover all areas with our mask. Up onto the forehead, not forgetting to leave that gap around the eye area, and nice sweeping movements all the way across the face, all the way up to the hairline and across the forehead. Ensure you've got a nice even application of the product. Apply two dampened eye pads. Open them out. And apply to the eye area. The mask may now be left on for 10 minutes. During this time, you can also do a head massage or a hand massage onto your client. Once your time has run up, take off the eye pads and begin to remove your mask with your sponges. So once again, pressure at the temples. And begin to remove the mask. And rinse the sponges out frequently. If you find your mask has become hard or solid, just place your damp sponges onto the surface of the mask, leave for a few seconds to help warm, and then remove. This will help soften the mask back down and remove it from the face. So ensure we get all areas, including the top lip. Once again, clean out our sponges. Work up either side of the nose. And across the forehead. Then, with clean sponges, we can go across the whole face to remove any traces of mask. So across the chin, turn our pads over, don't forget the top lip, up each side of the cheeks and the nose alternately, across the forehead, and repeat one last time. So pressure at the temples, across the chin, not forgetting the top lip, each side of the nose, and across at the forehead. And pressure to finish. With our tissue, remove any traces of excess water. So pressure at the cheeks, forehead and chin, and nose. Remove any excess oil from the chest area. And now we're ready to apply our toner. So with two damp cotton pads, apply toner to each. This just helps to close the pores after the steam and after the mask. So sweep across the chest, up the neck, across the chin, don't forget that top lip, across the cheeks, and pressure at the temples. And apply our moisturiser. Warm into the palm of the hands. Light pressure at the temples again. And firstly, just spread over the whole face, ensuring there's an even coverage. Then we can effleurage this moisturiser in. So with our chin brace, the sides of the nose, and across the forehead. And repeat till we've got a nice even coverage. Pressure the temples, and again with light circular movements, slowly getting slower and slower, finishing with the pressure. Remove our client's headband. And we have now completed our facial routine. Light pressure onto the eye pads, bring together and sweep out. Pressure, and we're going to repeat the process. This time, take one cotton pad, split into two. Make into two half moon shapes. Place underneath the eye. With a cotton bud, apply a small amount of eye makeup remover and roll the eyelashes, pushing any traces of mascara onto the cotton pad beneath. The other eye. Then with two more cotton pads, dampen, apply your eye makeup remover. And as in the first stage, apply on top of the eyes. Light pressure, bring up the centre, fold and wipe away any excess. Any mascara remaining, repeat the process again. Sponges over, across the chin, not forgetting the top lip, up the cheeks, one side of the nose at a time, and across the forehead. And we've completed our first cleanse. Now, apply more cleanser into the palm of the hand, a little bath of water, take off any excess. Pressure at the temples, sweep across, up the neck, brace the chin, palm stroking the side of the face, and the other side. Don't forget the top lip, small circles around the sides of the face, alternate circles up the nose, to the forehead, and then we do a scissor action across the forehead. This helps relax our client with a light massage. Sweep down and back into our chin brace. Our palm stroking, and the other side. Don't forget our top lip. Circles up the cheeks, either side of the nose, onto the forehead, and our scissor action. And And last and final time, sweep down, brace the chin, palm a stroking. We can now go on to our first cleanse. So if we apply some cleanser into the palm of our hand, a little bit of water, warming our palms, ensure there's no drip coming from our hands. Light pressure on the temples, sweep across the chest, up the neck, brace the chin, palm a stroke at the side of the chin. Catch the top lip and lightly circle up the cheeks till we reach the nose. At this point, ensure we place pressure on one nostril at a time, so we keep the airways open. Circle on the forehead. And light pressure at the temples to finish. With our damp sponges, take away any excess water, pressure at the temples, sweep across the chest, across the chest, sweep up the neck, turn up, not forgetting the top lip, circle on the cheeks, turn that circling on the nose, and again onto the forehead. And you can finish this last routine with small circles just on the temples to relax. A light pressure, and then we can remove with our sponges. Take off any excess water, start at the temples, sweep across the chest, up the neck, across the chin, not forgetting the top lip. Each side of the nose. And pressure at the temples. Ensuring there's no hair on the face. And there's no cleanser left. Just doing quick removal, just to ensure there's no cleanser left. Back all the way across the chest, up the neck. Not forgetting to turn our pads over, up the cheeks, either side of the nose, and pressure the temples. You can just blot this to ensure our client isn't becoming too cold just by using a tissue lightly onto the chest area, pressure with the back of our hand. Hello, my name is Louisa Ward and I'm a beauty therapist. I run my own private practice and work here at the Beauty Academy. Today I'm going to demonstrate to you a facial. I'm going to do the removal of eye makeup, two cleanses, an exfoliate, a steam, a massage, an application of a mask, removal of the mask, a tone and moisturise. So if we begin, take two pieces of cotton pad, dampen them, spread them out, and apply a small amount of eye makeup remover. Spread onto both pads and apply onto the eyes with a light pressure. As the eye makeup remover is working into the mascara, with two more pads, dampened once again, apply some more eye makeup remover ensuring that our pads are not dripping onto our client's face. Support one side of the lip, sweep over and back, and then support the other side and sweep over and back to remove any traces of lipstick. Come back to our client by touching the temples, around the cheeks, not forgetting the top lip, sides of the nose. Once again, alternate circles up the nose and onto the forehead. And this can be repeated. So back down to the chin, onto the cheeks, not forgetting the top lip, and onto the nose. And last and final time, onto the chin, top lip, and we can concentrate on areas that are particularly dry, which we can assess during our consultation. Around the sides of the nose and onto the forehead. Pressure at the temples again and remove with our sponges. Pressure on at the temples, up the neck, over the chin, cheeks, and across the forehead, and pressure. Pressure the temples, and look at your client's face to see where there's any remaining exfoliant left we need to remove. Working in a nice, slow, relaxing rhythm to remove all the exfoliant. Take off any excess water with our tissue again. And if your client is claustrophobic, we may place the tissue on one side of the face. Pressure and remove. The other side, pressure, remove. And then the chin, nose, and forehead. We would now be ready to steam. You would turn your steamer on, heated. So back down to the chin, onto the cheeks, not forgetting the top lip, and onto the nose. And last and final time, onto the chin, top lip. And we can concentrate on areas that are particularly dry, which we can assess during our consultation. Around the sides of the nose and onto the forehead. Pressure at the temples again them remove with our sponges. Pressure on at the temples, up the neck, over the chin. Cheeks and across the forehead and pressure. Pressure the temples and look at your client's face to see where there's any remaining exfoliant left we need to remove. Working in a nice, slow, relaxing rhythm to remove all the exfoliant. Take off any excess water with our tissue again. And if your client is claustrophobic, we may place the tissue on one side of the face. Pressure and remove. The other side, pressure, remove. And then the chin, nose, and forehead. We would now be ready to steam. You would turn your steamer on away from your client. Once you've got a good flow of steam, move it towards the back of the client and allow the steam to penetrate the skin. This can be left for up to 10 minutes depending on skin type. Ensure the steam is not too close to the face and your client is comfortable at all. Onto the cheeks, not forgetting the top lip, and onto the nose. And last and final time, onto the chin, top lip. And we can concentrate on areas that are particularly dry, which we can assist during our consultation. Around the sides of the nose and onto the forehead. Pressure at the temples again and remove with our sponges. Pressure on at the temples, up the neck, over the chin, the cheeks and across the forehead. And pressure. Pressure the temples. And look at your client's face to see where there's any remaining exfoliant left that we need to remove. Working in a nice, slow, relaxing rhythm to remove all the exfoliant. Take off any excess water with our tissue again. And if your client is claustrophobic, we may place the tissue on one side of the face, pressure, and remove. The other side, pressure, remove, and then the chin, nose, and forehead. We would now be ready to steam. You would turn your steamer on away from your client. Once you've got a good flow of steam, move it towards the back of the client. Allow the steam to penetrate the skin. This can be left for up to 10 minutes depending on skin type. Ensure the steam is not too close to the face and your client is comfortable at all times. One thing to remember is to ensure the steam does not come up the face. Ensure pressure on the occipital bone or the eye bone and sweep round. So pressure up and sweep below. Pressure up and sweep below. And this is very good for our clients who have any kind of sinus problems or stress, just to help relieve that tension. Come up and sweep below. Come up to our scissors on the forehead. And then we can sweep into our six full effleurage to finish. So nice slow rhythm. Come round. And really start to relax our client. Ensuring they're comfortable at all times. And your pressure is right for them. And on our final time, we sweep round. Brace the chin, up over the cheeks, onto the forehead, and finish with some light circles just on the temples, getting slower and slower until we finish. Make sure all our hair is out of the way, and we're now ready to apply our mask. So with our mask in a bowl, with a brush, paint on. Start at the jawline, up to the ear, and the other ear. Filling the chin. Dampen. Makeup remover, and as in the first stage, apply on top of the eyes. Light pressure, bring up the centre, fold and wipe away any excess. Any mascara remaining, repeat the process again. We can now go on to our first cleanse. So if we apply some cleanser into the palm of our hand, a little bit of water, warming our palms, ensure there's no drip coming from our hands. Light pressure on the temples, sweep across the chest, up the neck, brace the chin, palm a stroke either at the side of the chin. Catch the top lip and lightly circle up the cheeks till we reach the nose. At this point, ensure we place pressure on one nostril at a time so we keep the airways open. Circle on the forehead and light pressure at the temples to finish. With our damp sponges, take away any excess water, pressure at the temples, sweep across the chest, sweep up the neck, turn our sponges over, across the chin, not forgetting the top lip, up the cheeks, one side of the nose at a time, and across the forehead. And we've completed our first cleanse. Now, apply more cleansing ward, and I'm a beauty therapist. I run my own private practice and work here at the Beauty Academy. Today I'm going to demonstrate to you a facial. I'm going to do the removal of eye makeup, two cleanses, an exfoliate, a steam, a massage, an application of a mask, removal of the mask, a tone and moisturise. So if we begin, take two pieces of cotton pad, dampen them, spread them out, and apply a small amount of eye makeup remover. Spread onto both pads and apply onto the eyes with a light pressure. As the eye makeup remover is working into the mascara, with two more pads, dampened once again, apply some more eye makeup remover ensuring that our pads are not dripping onto our client's face. Support one side of the lip, sweep over and back, and then support the other side and sweep over and back to remove any traces of lipstick. Come back to our client by touching the temples. Light pressure onto the eye pads. Bring together and sweep out. Pressure, and we're going to repeat the process. This time, take one cotton pad, split into two. Make into two half moon shapes. Place underneath the eye. With a cotton bud, apply a small amount of eye makeup remover and roll the eyelashes, pushing any traces of mascara onto the cotton pad beneath. Work on the other eye. Two more cotton pads. And on our final time, we sweep round, brace the chin, up over the cheeks, onto the forehead, and finish with some light circles just on the temples, getting slower and slower until we finish. Make sure all our hair is out of the way, and we're now ready to apply our mask. So with our mask in a bowl with a brush, paint on. Start at the jawline, up to the ear, and the other ear. Filling the chin. Don't forget the top lip. Come up onto the cheeks, leaving a nice gap around the eyes, up to the temples on either side. Fill in the nose. Showing we cover all areas with our mask. Up onto the forehead. Not forgetting to leave that gap around the eye area. And nice sweeping movements all the way across the face. All the way up to the hairline. And across the forehead. Ensure you've got a nice even application of the product. The temples, and again with light circular movements, slowly getting slower and slower, finishing with the pressure. Remove our client's headband, and we have now completed our facial routine. Light pressure onto the eye pads, bring together and sweep out. Pressure, and we're going to repeat the process. This time, take one cotton pad, split into two. Make into two half moon shapes. Place underneath the eye. With a cotton bud, apply a small amount of eye makeup remover and roll the eyelashes, pushing any traces of mascara onto the cotton pad beneath. Work on the other eye. Two more cotton pads. Dampen. Apply your eye makeup remover. And as in the first stage, apply on top of the eyes. Light pressure. Bring up the centre. Fold and wipe away any excess. Any mascara remaining, repeat the process again. Our sponges over, across the chin, not forgetting the top lip, up the cheeks, one side of the nose at a time and across the forehead. And we've completed our first cleanse. Now, I'm ready to apply our toner. So with two damp cotton pads, apply toner to each. This just helps to close the pores after the steam and after the mask. So sweep across the chest, up the neck, across the chin, don't forget that top lip, across the cheeks, and pressure at the temples. And apply our moisturiser. Warm into the palm of the hands. Light pressure at the temples again. And firstly, just spread over the whole face, ensuring there's an even coverage. Then we can effleurage this moisturiser in. So with our chin brace, the sides of the nose, and across the forehead. And repeat till we've got a nice even coverage. Pressure the temples, and again with light circular movements, slowly getting slower and slower, finishing with a pressure. Remove our client's headband. And we have now completed our facial routine. Light pressure onto the eye pads, bring together and sweep out. Pressure, and we're going to repeat the process. This time, take one cotton pad, split into two. Now, apply more cleanser into the palm of the hand. Little bath of water. Take off any excess. Pressure at the temples. Sweep across. Up the neck. Brace the chin. Palms stroking the side of the face. And the other side. Don't forget the top lip. Small circles around the sides of the face. Alternate circles up the nose, to the forehead, and then we do a scissor action across the forehead. This helps relax our client with a light massage. Sweep down and back into our chin brace. Our palms stroking. The other side. Don't forget our top lip. Circles up the cheeks. Either side of the nose. Onto the forehead. And our scissor action. And last and final time, sweep down. Brace the chin. Palm is stroking. pressure. We can now go on to our first cleanse. So if we apply some cleanser into the palm of our hand, a little bit of water, warming our palms, ensure there's no drip coming from our hands. Light pressure on the temples, sweep across the chest, up the neck, brace the chin, palm a stroke either at the side of the chin. Catch the top lip.